Tim Hemman's best man? What? I'm going to be Tim Hemman's best man.
All right, Lewis. All right, Brian. I'm 90% certain I'm just going to throw in the towel and respray it. What?
I'm going to be Tim Hemman's best man.
What?
Tim Hemman's invited me to be his best man.
OK, well, that's clearly bollocks for a start-off. What did you say, Lewis?
I haven't said anything yet. I think, shall we say, it's a little bit far-fetched.
Yeah, well, come on then, Brian, this will be good. Why you?
Mate, I thought you meant to be giving me a lift down the pit.
Yeah, I am. I'm just coming.
Oh, yeah, funny. Looks like you're standing around talking to the others.
Yeah, all right. Brian's been saying... Go on, say it, Brian.
Yeah, but it doesn't sound 100% right now. I think about it
right,
again.
Right, OK. He's been saying he's going to be Tim Henman's best man.
He doesn't even like tennis.
But he's disillusioned with the idea now.
It does sound a little bit far-fetched.
Far-fetched isn't in it, mate.
Cut my head off.
Guys.
Brian, mate, what makes you think you're going to be Henman's best man?
I got a text.
Show us the text, Niven. Then.
Brian, mate, what does the text say?
It's appalling. It says, the number two, Brian, do you, with the letter, want to, again the number, be, the letter, best man at my wedding? I mean, I was just down at the project centre with Mr. De Freitas, and it came through and I thought, well, yes, I would like to do that. That would be an honour. So.
Ooh, this is getting a little bit too weird for me. I'm going to go down the garden centre.
No, Lewis, you're going to wait.
But the guy's clearly gone mad.
It's true, it might be that I've lost it a bit. What?
There!
But then again, why would he text me asking me to do that if he didn't want me to fulfil the role?
No, Brian, mate, it's probably not even from Henman. Yeah, that's probably not Henman's number. It's right. Probably just someone winding you up.
Scully, would it be okay if I used the landline and phoned the number that I got the text message from and found out whether it was from Tim Henman or if it's a crank text?
Of course.
Just squeeze by?
Yes.
Hemman's already married, isn't he? I mean... Scully, what do you make of all this, honestly?
Well, it's obviously very puzzling.
No, it's not very puzzling. The guy obviously has...
No, it's if you don't want my bat across your neck again, you'll do well to shut your teeth.
Now, we were all equally sceptical when he was made John Grisham's best man.
Not too bad, this war.
Sorry?
Just saying, not too bad, this war.
Very nice. Yeah. It's a goodie.
Yep. My name's Carl.
Ah, Jeff Plum. Yeah. I think I saw you in the orientation in the hangar.
Yes. Yes, I recognise your...
Fatigues?
Your face.
Oh, yes. My calling card.
Yes.
What do you do in the war?
I'm a relief worker.
Comic relief?
No. serious, distributing food and medicine and...
Presumably... a lot of heavy lifting, is it?
No, I mean, not for me. I've got AIDS, so I don't... Ah.
Just concentrate more on the admin. Cold calls.
I've got helpers. The locals. the locals lift. Very rude of me. Jeff, what do you do?
Oh, me, nothing. No.
You're a tourist?
But hardly here. No. I'm a lieutenant. For my sins. Yes.
I mean, actual kind of fighting.
Yes, fair bit of combat. Yes.
Wow.
Yes.
How do you do it?
Yes, how do you do? Nice to meet someone.
Yes, and I mean, so how do you do the fighting?
Ah. We have training.
Good.
Yes. So. I mean, I was trained in Colchester, but it can be any number of provincial town, and yes. Then it's off to the front line and make that area safe for king and country.
Yes. Yes. Or for queen and country.
Yes,
it?
As it is now. Yes. Times they are changing.
Are you enjoying this conversation?
Yeah, good. Pleasant. How long have you been a relief worker? Therein lies a tale.
Not long, a few weeks. I did sort of community work, kind of mural work and
regeneration project.
Exactly, and this is very much my first time in a
war zone.
Yeah, in a war zone. Yes.
Well, welcome.
Thank you.
I hope that doesn't happen.
Yes,
to
well,
you.
thank you again. Later in the day, if you're not busy, do you fancy a spot of
Is that tennis from the mine? Yeah. Yes. I'd love a game of tennis. Yes.
Great.
I should say no. I'm torn. I should say no. There's some enemy activity 2 kilometres north of the airfield, and I should make that safe. It's my responsibility. If you spend the whole week sort of saying to your troops, well, we need to make this area safe, and Saturday's the big day, and then you sort of turn up 20 minutes late and you're Fred Perry, it sends off the wrong place.
Yes, of course. And, well, be careful.
Always.
Yes. Yes. I mean, wear a helmet.
Oh, we're not cycling. We've got the tank, so...
No,
we're...
and... give them what for?
Oh, yes. Bullies.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it's political,
yes,
isn't it?
You're right, it is political. and they probably are. They're fighting for something they have conviction in, and as are we. And that's why war works. I'm not jumping.
You have to jump, Seb. Come on, jump.
I'm not jumping.
Make him stop saying that. I'm beginning to believe it.
Seb, you will jump. You are the stag, so you will jump.
I mean, can't you just strip me instead? I'm not queasy about being nude.
You've answered your own question, Seb. You don't mind getting your privates out, so that's playing into your hands. You do mind jumping off a clock tower into a sheet, so jumping off a clock tower into a sheet is what you'll do.
No, I'm not jumping.
If he says that one more time, I swear I'm going to headbutt him.
Oh, right, and with that headbutt, your best man duties will pass directly over to Ewan. And you'll be downgraded to a ticket that gets you into the wedding itself and the reception in the evening, but not to the dinner. So you won't even see you in speech.
Well, after seeing him shouting at the waitresses last night, I think I'd be more relaxed not listening to his aggressive regional accent.
But if you two would stop bickering for 10 seconds, Seb, jump. It's your last night of freedom. For the love of God, jump.
No. I'll die and get it in the neck from Crystal's parents.
You won't die. You can see for yourself how tautly your brothers are holding your raincoat. Your fall will be broken and we get on with paintballing and curry.
My neck will be broken more like, and we can get on with burials and serious inquests led by an appalled father-in-law.
Right, nappers to this, I'm jumping.
Okay. Seb, just because Claude's landed a bit awkwardly, that means we'll all. But he's not wearing a catsuit. You'll pierce the air more cleanly.
Keith.
Jump. Your brothers will try extra hard for you.
Keith, can we jump together?
I'd consider it an honour.
Oh, Keith. OK, let's do it.
Yes, and then scoop up Claude and off to the minibus.
Well, no, I mean, we'll just have to agree to disagree.
What's the conflict?
It's all right, Peter, we've agreed to disagree.
No, come on, I may be able to clear it up.
Right, only fools and horses.
Del Boy, Rodders, carry on.
Well, Ian says, you know the characters Trigger and Boise?
Marlene?
Yeah, well, Ian reckons... Well, they're not played by the same actor, are they, Peter?
Well, God, you phrased this so that he'll agree with you!
No, they're different actors.
Well, why are they never in the pub together, then?
The Nag's Head?
They are! Rodney's birthday! I'm...
The Seance!
Sorry to interrupt, gents. Has anyone got 250p's? It's just I'm planning to go to the pub.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.